Destek makul. Good morning everyone. I heartily welcome to all of you first year PUC to our Sangam Independent View College, Gangavati. And today we are going to start the online classes. Today is the computer science we are going to start over here. That is the first unit we are going to start here. That is fundamentals of computers. Okay. And before that, I need to give some instructions regarding the YouTube over here. So I will share some of the links regarding the classes over here in the WhatsApp group. Kindly use that link to watch the online classes and please subscribe the channel to get the update of the classes over here. Yeah? Okay, be with the WhatsApp group over here. Don't delete any kinds of link in the WhatsApp group and don't exit from the group over here. Okay, then we'll start the computers. That is the fundamentals of computers we are going to start over here. So, fundamentals of computers. As we know that the fundamentals of computers means the basic needs of computers over here. We need to learn what exactly the computer means over here. That is the meaning of a computer. As we know that the computer is an electronic device. Yeah, it is an electronic device we need to see here. So what exactly we need to see here? Just if the computer will go, what exactly? When the input should be taken from the computer, that is from the devices, and it will process the data and it will perform the output to the user over here. That is storing, processing and getting the output over. That is what exactly we did in the computer. That is called as a computer called as a electronic devices we need to say here. Here, whenever we go with the computer systems, we need to know three things. One is first, that is input, and the second one is the process, and third one is that is output. IP is nothing but an input. Don't get confusion over here. IP is what exactly the IP is. The input, and this is called as the output over here. And these are the three basic things that is called as the preparations of the things over we need to see here. If you want to know what exactly the computer is going to perform in the sense, you need to know the input, process, and as well as the output over here. So what exactly the input is going to take over here? That is, so input is nothing but whenever we want to work with the computer systems, we need devices to take the input from the input, to give the input to the system over here. The inputs are nothing but a keyboard, a joysticks, and as some of the touch screens we need to say here, that is what is the devices we need to take over, that is input only to say here. And when you are going to process, so whatever the data is taken from the user over here, that should be processed in the CPU, that is called as the processing should be done over. That is nothing but storing we have here, processing we have here, that is ALU, CPU, CU, we have lot of the things we are doing with the CPU over. That is called as a processing over here. Finally, after we are processing the entire data, which is taken from the input devices, finally we need to place the output. Output is nothing but as your the screen, where exactly we need to see the output of the data which has been processed over here. So this process is called as a computer, that is base fundamentals of computer we need to say here. Okay, then let us go with the next one. Characteristics of computer. The characteristics are a speed, memory, storage, accuracy, versatility, so that is M. So we are taking out of this 7, we are taking as a 5 things. That is the characteristics of a computer. The characteristics of computers, the what do you mean by characteristics? That is a some other name is called as the features of computer, we need to say here. So before going to buy any kinds of a computer, we need to see the some of the features of the devices. In the same year also, we need to know that the what are the characteristics of computers. In the sense, the characteristics of computers are nothing but the speed, memory, storage, and as well as the accuracy and versatility, we need to say here. The speed, so what exactly the speed means over here? The speed is nothing but how much time it will take to process the data when you have taken the input from the user. That is the speed we need to say here. The memory, the memory is nothing but, so whenever we need a certain storage into the computer system, that is nothing but a memory we need to see here. So memory should have some of the like a RAM and ROM we need to see here. RAM and as well as a ROM we need to see here. And come with the next one, that is the storage purpose we need to see here. The storage is nothing but as a primary storage and as well as a secondary storage. The primary storage is nothing but as a main memory storage, that is RAM and ROM we need to see here. Apart from we have secondary storage devices, that is called as external storage device we need to say here, that is called hard disk we need to say here, that is HDD, hard disk device we need to say here. So where exactly whenever we are going to process the data it should be entirely stored into the hard disk devices. And the last one, accuracy. So accuracy in the sense, whatever the data should be taken from the user, that should be processed the data and then it should get as accurate result, that is called as accuracy we need to say here. And versatility we need to say here, what exactly the versatility in the sense. So the versatility is saying that almost